Tom Pritchard, I'm Kevin Kelly. We welcome you to Metal. Last Sunday at No Way Out, we saw the return of Shane McMahon and the end of Mick Foley's career. We'll talk about that and a whole lot more in the hour.
Introducing first, weighing 282 pounds, Test!
It's great to see Test back off the injured list, Tom, but I know there is an entire planet full of Mick Foley fans that are mourning the loss of their favorite superstar.
Well, Mick Foley fully well knew the consequences of No Way Out, Hell in a Cell with Triple H. It was either come out the champion or lose his career.
His opponent, weighing 304 pounds, Midian!
So Tess will do battle with Midian here as we kick off a huge hour of Metal. And as I mentioned earlier on, the return of Shane McMahon at No Way Out, shocking us all and costing The Rock an opportunity to compete in the main event at WrestleMania.
And everybody wondered, why would Shane McMahon come back now when he found out on Raw that Shane McMahon wanted to make sure nobody got stronger than the World Wrestling Federation?
Well, Triple H is the WWF champion. His wife, Stephanie McMahon Helmsley, they lay claim to all the power. But now, Tom, maybe with Shane McMahon kind of guiding the Big Show on his way to WrestleMania, that's been where this power struggle could all lie.
Well, we almost saw a civil war take place on Raw between Shane and Stephanie, and I gotta believe that the McMahon family is coming to grips here with something even more bigger than the World Wrestling Federation Championship.
Of course, civil war really nearly broke out as SmackDown came to a close this past Thursday night. We'll speculate on the future, the power struggle between Shane and Stephanie McMahon Helmsley, and a whole lot more as Midian drills Test with a hard right hand. Now, Test was on the injured list for a few weeks, Tom. We understand with a bit of a bad back. How much time for recovery will Test need? Will it be full speed here this week on Metal?
I don't know if he'll be full speed this week on Metal, but I can guarantee you after one or two matches, he's gonna know how his body will react.
Well, we know how his body reacted following the loss of the hardcore title against Crash Holly, who now apparently is going to defend the hardcore championship. 24-7 power slam out of the corner. Two almost had him. That's right, folks. Crash Holly said to Tom Thursday on SmackDown that anytime, any place, anywhere, anybody with a WWF official can get a hardcore match. What do you think about that?
I'm wondering what Crash Holly's thinking about that. What in the world would possess him to want to defend the hardcore championship 24-7?
So we're talking about out of the confines of an arena. Wait a minute, a cover, just a one count. Where could these matches happen, Tom? Are we talking any place?
Any place, a hotel lobby, a restaurant? On the street, obviously, as long as there is a WWF official in tow.
Imagine that, Crash Holly in a hotel lobby, in a gas station. All of those scenarios are apparently possible as Crash now puts the Hardcore Championship up 24-7. Boy, what's going through The Rock's mind? At No Way Out, it appeared as if the Great One was on cruise control, ready to get through the Big Show and head right to WrestleMania. But thanks to Shane McMahon, The Rock's dreams of being in the main event are now on hold. While The Rock, of course, will be at WrestleMania, he can forget about the main event.
You've got to believe The Rock is disappointed and also as mad as he's ever been in the World Wrestling Federation. He was not only denied going to WrestleMania, but he was denied giving the people's elbow to the Big Show.
Couple elbows to the midsection. Test extricates himself, and Midian drills Test with a DDT. Can Midian make the cover? He does. Does not hook the leg, though. 2-1. Boy, Test's shoulder just rolls out before the count of three. We'll see the headbangers a little later on in the hour, as well as the light heavyweight championship on the line. S.A. Rios with Lita defending against Funaki. Plus, Tom, a special video tribute to Mick Foley.
Wow. What a video tribute it is, too, to a special man here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Double clothesline. Both Midian and Test are feeling the effects of this contest. Plus, the Godfather and D'Lo Brown will face the Big Boss Man and Prince Albert, who Boss Man and Prince Albert certainly have made a habit of going after Taz as of late, who's proven to be quite unstoppable. Look at this now. Slugfest. Oh. Midian, head of steam, misses with the clothesline. Test gets that big boot up. Oh, man. Runs right through Midian with a clothesline of his own. And you're right, Tom. It appears as if Test is back full steam, 100%.
Well, Test has a good... Oh, man, I was just going to say a good test, so to speak, in Midian. Now, here's a cover.
Wait a minute now. Look at this. Oh, wow. The feet on the ropes.
But Test busted enough strength to kick out, which is showing that he has a lot of back strength left.
Knee to the midsection. No way.
Yes.
Can Test actually do? Yes, he does. The pump handle power slam. And now Test is going to the top. Midian, center of the ring, a long way away.
Can he make it?
Oh, drills it. Hook of the leg, two. This one's over.
Here is your winner, Test.
An impressive victory by Test this week. And if there's any questions on how his back is feeling, they were answered just then.
Very impressive victory by Test. And of course, Tom, we're all still talking about what a huge event, what a great event No Way Out was, albeit a bittersweet one. The loss inside Hell in a Cell and the retirement of Cactus Jack.
That's right, Kevin. And the next night on Raw, we saw The Rock yet receive another opportunity to become the number one contender for the World Wrestling Federation Championship. We saw Shane McMahon return at No Way Out. We'll cover that and a whole lot more in the hour.
And Tom, for more on No Way Out, let's go to the coast. 4 weeks away from WrestleMania, two big titles changed hands, though, at No Way Out last Sunday.
It's scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, at a combined weight of 492 pounds, Mosh and Crusher, the Headbanger.
Headbangers in tag team action, Tom.
Combined weight of 438 pounds, Kevin Landry and the Inferno Kid.
Be interesting to see what the Inferno Kid and Kevin Landry can do against the Headbangers this week.
The Dudley Boys are the new tag team champions. Billy Gunn's future in DX is in doubt. Plus, Kurt Angle now owns Intercontinental Gold as well. As I mentioned, we are 4 weeks away from WrestleMania. It's been sold out for months. But you could be part of WWF Access, Tom, a unique three-day fan festival taking place the weekend of WrestleMania.
Well, Access is a three-day fan festival where WWF fans will enjoy the opportunity to obtain autographs and photographs of their favorite WWF superstars, sample WWF merchandise, and experience WrestleMania weekend in a personal and interactive way.
Tickets are on sale now at the Anaheim Convention Center, all Southern California Ticketmaster locations, and online at Ticketmaster.com. You don't want to miss anything having to do with WWF Access. Well, the Inferno Kid had moved very smartly. Now Kevin Landry and his tag team partners doing the same. Got the Headbangers rocking and rolling here.
Oh,
nobody home. Wait a minute now. Up on the shoulders, Landry finds himself in a precarious position.
Man.
Not exactly a nice way to fall.
Rushed into that corner in what would be called a rookie mistake. And Mosh capitalized on it.
Boy, no mistakes made by the Dudley Boys. The sadistic way that Bubba Ray Dudley cracked Billy Gunn in the shoulder with that lead pipe, which then, of course, led to a 3D on Road Dogg and new tag team champions at No Way Out. And Tom, we know that Billy Gunn is on the injured list with a badly injured shoulder.
And we know that Triple H and DX were very unhappy with the loss as well, and showed him just how unhappy they were last Monday on Raw.
Is Billy Gunn out of DX? His immediate future, of course, is filled with surgery to repair that injured shoulder. But what happens when he comes back? Will he still wear the black and green of DX? We don't know right now. And we, of course, will keep you updated on that story as Kevin Landry attempts to mount a bit of a comeback here. Bringing up the left arm. Modified fireman's carry up on the shoulder. Oh, man. Almost dropped Mosh right on his head. Cover. Hook of the leg. Two. Two count only.
Well, Landry's on fire here in this match.
If he can put some tag team combinations together with the Inferno Kid, we might move very well. But wait a minute, blind tag. Landry did not even see it. Stage dive out of nowhere. This one is over.
Here are your winners, the Headbanger.
Well, the Dudley Boys are the new tag team champions. Kurt Angle wears Intercontinental Gold. We got a lot more action to come. Still on metal. We'll see the light heavyweight title on the line. S.A. Rios with Lita will defend against Kyan Tai's Fundaki.
And up next, I suggest you set your VCRs. We'll have an amazing tribute to the career of Mick Foley.
Who'd ever believe that a man and a woman would actually have relationship problems here in the World Wrestling Federation, Tom?
Yeah, especially Lita and S.A.
Well, maybe they can put their differences together. We'll see how they work as a team here. But Lita's showing she's got some fire in her belly as well. Light heavyweight titles on the line next.
Scheduled for one fall is for the World Wrestling Federation Light Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first, accompanied by Lita from Guadalajara, Mexico, weighing 215 pounds, the World Wrestling Federation Light Heavyweight Champion, S.A. Rio.
Well, they look good together. They work good together. Apparently, they fight good together as well. S.A. Rios defending the light heavyweight title. He will have Lita in his corner against Funaki. But S.A. Rios is not the only one with women problems here in the World Wrestling Federation.
His opponent and challenger from Japan, weighing 204 pounds, Funaki.
Funaki the challenger. And Tom, I'm talking, of course, about Terry, who surprised us all at No Way Out by returning, first of all, and then turning on Matt and Jeff Hardy.
Boy, you had to wonder what was going through Terry's mind, but, I mean, she was upset that they only came and visited her, like, 2 days out of the week. And obviously, these guys have to be on the road. I'm talking about the Hardy boys, and maybe they couldn't get to the hospital every day, Terry.
Well, we had speculated on Terry's mental state following being put through a table by Bubba Ray Dudley. He said that she was haunted by nightmares and things like that, but never expected her to act so irrationally as she did. So then it looked as if Terry was going to be with Edge and Christian. But after Monday on Raw and Thursday on SmackDown, Tom, I'm not so sure that Edge and Christian want anything to do with Terry.
I'm not so sure anybody should want anything to do with Terry after the way she's been acting lately. I mean, she definitely has some problems.
You can't really trust that she-devil.
Wow.
And the problems of Tori. Boy, JR called it right. Old Tombstone Tori, wearing the neck brace still, but played a major role in X-Pac's victory over Kane at No Way Out.
Tori may be feeling the effects of the tombstone, but at the same time, ooh, she's doing X-Pac well by being at his side.
Drop kick to the quadricep. S.A. Rios looking to knock the blocks out. Oh, powerbomb! S.A. Rios is a phenomenal athlete. There is only one in the World Wrestling Federation, cover and a two count only. And of course, you can't talk about the women of the World Wrestling Federation, Tom, without mentioning your favorite, Mae Young.
Boy, you're not kidding. In fact, this Sunday on Heat, Mae will team with Mark Henry against Midian and Ivory in an intergender matchup.
That's this Sunday on Heat, 7, 6 Central on the USA Network. Irish whip to the buckle. S.A. Rios runs into the bottom of Funaki's boot. Misses with the splash attempt and a nice bulldog out of the corner. Look of concern on Lita's face. Two, almost had a new champion. Boy, and as I mentioned earlier, Kane, X-Pac, No Way Out. Tori playing a major role in X-Pac's win, but that apparently is not stopping the rampage that Kane has been on as of late.
The Big Red Machine is still on fire, looking for X-Pac, looking for Tori, and anybody else that wants to get in his way.
What about Devon Dudley being put through a table? Thursday on SmackDown. It's the last thing the Dudleys ever expected. Baseball slide into the head scissors.
And S.A. Rios really taking it to Funaki.
S.A. can strike at any angle. So acrobatic. He is the most unique athlete in the World Wrestling Federation. Having some words with Jakked. Wait a minute now. Look at Lita.
What is she doing in the ring?
Apparently the same move that S.A. Rios did. Lita loves to mimic what S.A. Rios does.
Wow.
Have you ever seen a tandem like Lita and S.A. Rios?
Oh, no, I actually can't say I have.
I mean, what is it about this relationship? There seems to be so much fire and chemistry between the two.
And they both have the same hair color as well. I mean, that obviously fits into the equation. I mean, ooh, powerbomb. This should do it. Two.
Wow. Funaki still showing he's not done yet. Kicking out of that pinning combination.
He'll give S.A. his due. He is a talented athlete. And so is Lita.
Firing into the corner with a forearm. Now going to go for a tornado DDT.
Seen this before.
Oh, ooh, the good counter. S.A. Rios knew it was coming, but misses with the clothesline. Now Funaki, elevation. Wait a minute. Oh, great counter once again from S.A. Rios.
Funaki's in trouble.
These two men have met on many occasions. They seem to know each other like a book. Now S.A. going to the top. Moonsault.
Nice.
That'll do it. Still the light heavyweight champion is S.A. Rios.
And wait a minute. Top.
Anything he can do, she can do, perhaps better.
The winner of this bout, and still late heavyweight champion, S.A. Rios.
Well, as long as she doesn't get caught by the referee, she possibly can do anything he can do. I don't know if she can do it better, though, Kevin.
Well, I'm just making a point. As long as S.A.'s not getting disqualified for Lita's actions, S.A. appears to be good with it.
Well, he's still the light heavyweight champion, and they worked for him this week, that's for sure.
Still a lot more action to come here on WWF Metal, including teacher and student in tag team action. The Boss Man and Prince Albert team against The Godfather and D'Lo Brown.
And up next, The Rock tries to battle his way into the main event at WrestleMania. The highlights from Raw.
Despite suffering an enormous amount of punishment at the hands of the Big Boss Man and Prince Albert, Taz just kept coming at no way out.
Well, despite Boss Man and Albert's best efforts, I don't think Taz's mood is going to change one bit.
The following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, at a combined weight of 588 pounds, D'Lo Brown and The Good.
As the Godfather's ladies go two by two down the ramp, we can tell you folks that the countdown to WrestleMania is on. And the war that apparently is breaking out within the McMahon family talk would greatly impact the complexion of WrestleMania's main event. With the Big Show and Shane McMahon on one side, Triple H and Stephanie McMahon Helmsley on the other, the question of who really holds the power in the WWF needs to be asked.
Well, I want to know who holds the power in the WWF, but I also want to ask the question, how far will the Boss Man and Prince Albert go to take out Taz?
Well, if they did, Boss Man and Prince Albert felt the wrath of the Orange and Black Attack.
Their opponents, at a combined weight of 652 pounds, Prince Albert and the Big Boss Man.
Prince Albert and the Boss Man with a bad mood on their face this week.
I would imagine they were somewhat humiliated, not being able to get the job done. At No Way Out, Raw last Monday, SmackDown last Thursday. I have a feeling they're not going to stop. Who knows, the attacks could continue when Raw is live this Monday.
We can say that Taz definitely won't be backing up from these two guys.
Taz is relentless.
No, I'm going to do this. I'm tired of y'all cutting my music. It's time, once again, for everybody to come aboard the...
So who does hold the power within the McMahon family? Who is the strongest force, Tom? Is it Stephanie McMahon Helmsley with the WWF Champion Triple H, or is it Shane McMahon with the 7-foot, 500-pound monster Big Show?
You've really got to wonder who is in charge. Stephanie and Triple H have been dealing the cards as of late, and Shane just walks into the picture and makes a tremendous impact. But you really have to ask yourself, who is the main, who is the final word in the World Wrestling Federation right now?
About to break out here in the World Wrestling Federation. You mentioned Stephanie and Triple H holding all the cards, but Shane definitely dealt himself a full house, acquiring the services of the 7-foot, 500-pound Big Show, shelving The Rock's plans for an appearance in the main event at WrestleMania. We know the great one is going to be there at WrestleMania on Sunday, April 2nd, but it is going to be Triple H and the Big Show for the World Wrestling Federation Championship. Look at the power of Prince Albert. D'Lo doing his best to fight out of the grips of that massive man.
Wow. Nice up and under by D'Lo.
Big collision, running right into the chest. I mean, there are not too many individuals in the World Wrestling Federation that combine the size and agility of Prince Albert.
Or the nasty disposition as well.
Well, that certainly is being fostered by the Big Boss Man. How beneficial is it for Prince Albert to have the Big Boss Man in his corner?
I don't think he could have a better mentor in the World Wrestling Federation. The Boss Man will teach this Prince Albert how to go after somebody and stay on him.
Nice drop toehold there from D'Lo Brown. The tag is made, and here comes the Godfather. The ladies are cheering at ringside. Drop down right into a slam. Runs the Boss Man. Head of steam. D'Lo with the splash, and look out. Roll around with the leg drop. Very nicely done.
Godfather's on fire this week on Metal.
I have a feeling that Raw is going to be sizzling hot this Monday, live, 9, 8 Central on the USA Network. Maybe we'll find, oh man, right out in front of us, Godfather, hard to the floor. Maybe we'll find out who really does hold all the cards. Who wields the power in the World Wrestling Federation? Is it Shane McMahon with the Big Show? Is it Stephanie McMahon Helmsley with Triple H? We'll find out perhaps this Monday.
Right now it looks like Boss Man and Prince Albert are holding all the cards with the Godfather.
What Boss Man and Prince Albert have done to the human wrecking machine Taz is virtually inhuman. But despite their best efforts, they have yet to keep Taz down. And I have a feeling Taz isn't going to stop. There may be no stopping Taz at all.
I mean, coming from Brooklyn, we've heard about Taz talking about half of his friends are dead or in jail, and I think he's just one of the lucky ones who broke out and come to the WWF with the highest expectations possible. It's not going to be easy with Prince Albert and Boss Man in your way.
Cover, two count only. Taz fighting for survival here in the World Wrestling Federation. He fought for survival growing up in the Red Hook section of Brooklyn, and that same fight is carrying on here in the WWF. And now, the Godfather is in a precarious position. Look at this. Oh, my goodness. The velocity as Godfather's neck snaps across that second strand.
A little extra help by Boss Man on the outside.
Boy, this Sunday night on Heat, it is going to be an incredible hour. First time ever an intergender tag team match featuring Mae Young and Mark Henry against Ivory and Midian. Plus, Tom, I understand the Acolytes Protection Agency is going to be open for business.
Wow. The Acolytes are doing pretty good with the APA, I understand.
Bradshaw certainly doing good in the stock market.
Unbelievable.
We saw that on his appearance on CNBC this past week, and the tag is made. D'Lo Brown is in. Hard right hand drops Prince Albert. D'Lo Brown showing him. He's got a lot of fire in that balled up right fist. Prince Albert looks to elevate D'Lo. Drop kick. Wait a minute now. Boss Man comes in without benefit of the tag. Sky high. Boss Man's head cracks on the canvas. Prince Albert. Whoa, what strength from D'Lo. 375.
Looking for a leg drop. Yes!
What's going on the floor here, Tom?
Well, the Boss Man just threw the Godfather into those steps, and not a good move by D'Lo Brown.
Setting up for the lowdown, the Boss Man able to counter. Now going for Prince Albert's briefcase.
Oh, wait a minute.
The Godfather's ladies put up a protest.
They just put in a slap on the Boss Man. Oh, look at D'Lo.
Referee slide to the ring. This one's over. Oh, wait a minute.
Oh, the Boss Man not too happy about this one.
Boy, this match is over. The Godfather and D'Lo Brown are victorious. But that mean streak coming out once again in the Boss Man and Prince Albert. Boss Man slam. Prince Albert with D'Lo on his shoulders.
And this is the viciousness being installed in Prince Albert by the Boss Man. And there are your winners on the mat.
Oh, my goodness. The onslaught continues. Perhaps the Boss Man and Prince Albert are sending out a message, Tom.
Possibly to Taz.
Well, the human wrecking machine is all ears. And the collision course between Taz, the Big Boss Man, and Prince Albert far from over. Once again, let's visit our old friend, the coach. WrestleMania, The Rock finds himself in a very desperate situation. Along with Tom Pritchard, I'm Kevin Kelly. Welcome to the medal.
From Chicago, Illinois, weighing 268 pounds, D'Lo Brown.
Wow, what a shot we saw Shane take this past week on Raw, but it all ended in the week with a little compromise, Kevin.
We thought it was going to be civil war with Stephanie slapping Brother Shane Monday on Raw. But Thursday on SmackDown, it all turned out to be a big compromise in which common enemies are now the focus of the new coalition.
Accompanied by Lita from Guadalajara, Mexico, weighing 215 pounds,
the World Wrestling Federation Light Heavyweight Champion, S.A. Rios.
Athletic sensation, light heavyweight champion, S.A. Rios, with the lovely Lita in his corner to do battle non-title style against D'Lo Brown as we kick off a huge hour of metal. Later on, you want to talk about an unlikely pairing, Tom. We're going to see, for the first time ever, Taz in tag team action here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Teaming up with Tess this week, I think it's going to be a perfect test for both of them to see if they can coexist together.
Against the Big Boss Man and Prince Albert, that will be a very physical tag team contest. And Tom, it all seems to be the theme of this week. Unlikely partnerships against common enemies. And we really saw that take shape Monday on Raw when it all began in a very uncivil manner between Shane and Stephanie.
Well, I think Shane and Stephanie finally came to their senses and realized it's better to coexist and work together. This way they can accomplish what they want here in the World Wrestling Federation.
And that, of course, is keeping common enemies down. And not just The Rock, but also Kane and Rikishi. They all felt the sting of the coalition now that exists between the members of the McMahon family and the two men that will meet in the main event at WrestleMania. Lita with a look of consternation on her face on the outside. D'Lo's got a huge weight advantage in this contest against S.A. Rios. So how does the light heavyweight champion hang with D'Lo?
Just like that, you've got to use your speed on a match like this, especially against a heavyweight, a full-fledged heavyweight in D'Lo Brown. Nice move by S.A. Rios.
And another hurricanrana nicely done there by the light heavyweight champion. A lot of people would say, Tom, that D'Lo Brown is a light heavyweight in a heavyweight's body.
No doubt about it, D'Lo has the speed and skill of a light heavyweight, but he is a full-fledged heavyweight. And S.A. Rios throwing those heavyweight chops on D'Lo.
S.A. Rios following in the corner, and D'Lo Brown is in some trouble. The question that's on my mind, Tom, is why did Shane McMahon return to the World Wrestling Federation in the first place? We saw him return, of course, at No Way Out.
Shane made it clear that he doesn't want anybody, especially The Rock, to become that icon such as Stone Cold Steve Austin has here in the World Wrestling Federation, and he'll do anything he can to stop that.
Ooh! Man. D'Lo lighting up S.A. Rios. Pounding away on the light heavyweight champion in the corner. And now getting up in Teddy Long's face.
Well, this is where S.A. doesn't want to get caught in the corner like that. He needs to use his speed to get out.
Lita and S.A. Rios have been quite a tandem, very successfully working together in the World Wrestling Federation. Wait a minute. Chopping the legs out, two count only. It seems that everything that S.A. Rios does, Lita looks to do as well, Tom.
Well, Lita can get in trouble for that, too. She wants to step into the ring. Sometimes copying somebody is great. Copying S.A. Rios can be dangerous.
Well, imitation is the sincerest form of flattery, as they say, but it has led to some problems. A few bumps in the road, I guess you could say, in the relationship between S.A. Rios and Lita. She likes what she sees now, but we'll see what happens as this contest continues. D'Lo's tag team partner, the Godfather, will be in action a little later on here in the hour, taking on Midian. Plus, as we said, Taz makes his metal debut in a tag team matchup with Test against the Big Boss Man and Prince Albert. And in a week in which we saw some very unlikely pairings, Todd, a very unlikely partnership, I guess, is developed now between Kurt Angle and the former World Wrestling Federation champion, Bob Backlund.
Wow, two American heroes together here in the World Wrestling Federation.
You like this?
I like it. I think it's great. Bob Backlund coming in, applying the crossface chicken wing, and Kurt Angle. I mean, here are the two American heroes that everybody should be looking up to.
Well, Kurt Angle, of course, is very successful here in the World Wrestling Federation, not just the Olympic gold medalist, but also both the Intercontinental and European champion. Bob Backlund, a former WWF champion, but he's retired. He's running for Congress, of all things.
Well, you know what they say, politicians will do anything to get your vote, and I think he's got Kurt Angle's vote.
D'Lo now beginning to open up the offense on S.A. Rios. This is a non-title contest. And I think S.A. Rios, in any language, is getting to become familiar with the leg drop. Cover, hooking the leg, Teddy Long in position. Two count only, though, before S.A. Rios is able to kick out. What we said right at the top, desperate men are capable of desperate things. And after everything that Stephanie, Shane, and their respective charges did to the Great One this past week, you have to wonder what The Rock will do next. Sky high.
Well, I've got to believe The Rock has nothing to lose, and all he wants to do is make life miserable for Shane and Stephanie McMahon-Helmsley.
Looks like D'Lo's gonna end things here with the lowdown.
Now wait a minute.
Well, I know that Lita is very visually attractive, but a distraction nonetheless. Essay goes up and gets D'Lo from the top. Cover two and I thought he had it.
Not quite, but that was not a smart move by D'Lo to be paying attention to Lita on the outside when you're on that top turnbuckle.
Something seems to be wrong with D'Lo lately. I'm not sure, a little lack of focus at times. D'Lo chest first to the buckle, and now S.A. Rios to the top.
Come on.
Getting ready to deliver the tornado DDT. No, sir. Carrot smart. Oh, wait a minute. Something's wrong with S.A.'s knee. Wait a minute. Opening the door for Lita. Wait a minute.
It doesn't look like that knee's hurt too bad.
And now S.A. Rios is going to the top. Oh! Moonsault! This one is over. The great team work between S.A. Rios and Lita continues to pay dividends, Tom.
Well, obviously, it's been to S.A.'s advantage to have Lita at ringside, but can't say the same for his opponents as of late.
Boy, in a week filled with unlikely pairings, the very likely pairing of S.A. and Lita continues to pay dividends.
Well, Kevin, some may call it an upset. Others may say it's a sign of things to come.
And, Tom, that has to be considered a bit of a surprise. But the road to WrestleMania appears to be getting quite rocky, I guess you could say, for Shane and Stephanie McMahon-Helmsley.
And, Kevin, both Triple H and The Big Show felt the wrath of The Rock on the road to WrestleMania this past. We'll cover that and a whole lot more in this hour.
That big kick punctuated a big week for Steve Blackman with singles victories over both Hardy Boys, Tom.
Wow. But I think Blackman still needs a little help with the personality side of his life.
Why can't he just get with the phenomenon known as head cheese?
Wow.
Did you ever, I mean, in your career, any fans ever come up to you and just be desperate to have their picture taken with you?
Not desperate, no. Not as desperate as some people are wanting to have their picture taken with head cheese, Steve Blackman.
Yeah, Steve Blackman really was rather forceful with that fan on SmackDown on Thursday. That was actually very funny.
Wow.
Well, Thrasher here against Funaki next up on Metal. Thrasher taking a side headlock very quickly. Thrasher, his tag team partner, Mosh, is down at ringside. Funaki very successful last Sunday on Heat as he employed the services of the Acolyte Protection Agency against the Mean Street Posse, Tom.
I wonder how much the APA charged Funaki.
I'm not sure whether it was dollars or yen or... I'm not quite sure.
Well, you know, Bradshaw's very apt in the stock market, so I don't know if he gave Funaki some advice or just got a few thousand to play with.
Face first down goes Thrasher. When all was said and done last Sunday on Heat, Funaki kept the Mean Street Posse's record perfect.
Oh, man, come on.
Yeah, it's absolutely perfect. Not a blemish. They have yet to win a match here in the World Wrestling Federation. We know that this Sunday night on Heat, the Acolyte Protection Agency is once again going to be open for business, Tom. Wait a minute now. Crossbody off the second rope, two count only. And anytime the APA hangs the open sign, there is bound to be trouble. Oh, look at this.
Mosh on the outside pulling down the top rope.
Not only this Sunday on Heat, come on, not only this Sunday on Heat will the APA be open for business, but Chris Jericho is going to be in action. Y2J to battle one of the Radicals, Dean Malenko. Jericho, Malenko, one-on-one this Sunday night on Heat. And now Thrasher, with the benefit from his partner, only gets a two count.
And Kevin, coming up next, speaking of Chris Jericho, we'll cover his problems this past week with Kurt Angle and Bob Backlund.
Think about Chris Jericho this Sunday on Heat. He faces a pretty good odds of finding himself in a four-on-one situation where one radical goes, the others usually follow. Thrasher stomping away on Funaki. And we mentioned, of course, the problems earlier on of the Mean Street Posse. They're still without a win here in the World Wrestling Federation. But they seem to be focused on winning the Hardcore Championship away from Crash Holly, who is now defending his title in a most unique fashion as Mosh pounds away behind the referee's back. Come on! Really aggressive is Mosh. I mean, what's the story with Crash Holly wanting to defend his Hardcore title 24/7, 365?
I think he's got enough confidence that he could fill this entire arena right now. And the Mean Street Posse has just as much confidence because I think all three of them could probably beat Crash.
Yes, but they find themselves each wanting the victory and fighting amongst themselves. And they're unable to get the job done, and Crash has so far been able to escape.
All the Main Street Posse needs is focus, focus, focus.
They need a little more than focus.
Wow.
They need some good luck charms. Need some help.
That's not going to work. Eventually, these guys are going to win a match, and they possibly could win the Hardcore Championship.
Yeah, when hell freezes over.
Wait a minute.
Sunset Flip attacked here. Can Funaki pull Thrasher over? I think Thrasher is split his shorts.
Wait
good
a minute.
Lord. Come on.
Yep. Look at that.
He definitely has split his shorts, folks. I don't know if he's ever washed those things, so who knows? Oh, wait a minute. Almost a meeting of the minds there. Up. Oh, the inevitable happened. Roll up.
Got him.
Funaki didn't do business with him. Mosh and Thrasher, a couple of sore losers.
Well, it would have done good for Funaki to go visit Bradshaw and Farouk. Oh, man. For this match.
Bad news for Funaki. He gets the win, but winds up flat on his back. Headbangers make a definitive statement. But still to come here on WWF Metal, the train is just about ready to pull into the station as the Godfather will do battle against Midian.
And up next, Chris Jericho runs into some trouble at the hands of Bob Backlund. The highlights from Raw and SmackDown.
The tears streaming down Mark Henry's face are very real. He's very scared for the well-being of his girlfriend, Bayana.
Well, maybe she'll listen to him next time.
I think it's terrible that people cannot feel safe coming down to ringside, being part of their boyfriend's matches if they so choose.
Well, if you come down to ringside, you're a fair game for any superstar here in the World Wrestling Federation, as The Rock found out with the Dudleys last week on SmackDown.
Well, the Godfather has conjured up a spell and delivered four beauties here for this capacity crowd. It ain't easy. Sometimes it's harder than others.
The following contest is scheduled for one round. Introducing first from the Red Light District, weighing 320 pounds.
Godfather set for one-on-one battle against Midian. And boy, oh boy, anytime there is a World Wrestling Federation live event, Tom, one thing is for sure, it's going to sell out and sell out fast.
And that's because of the guys like the Godfather, the superstars in the World Wrestling Federation, coming to the ring with his ladies. Anytime he's in the house, you know there's going to be fireworks.
Events sold selling out in record time, such as Madison Square Garden selling out in one day, a 10th straight sellout at MSG, and an upcoming event in Washington, D.C. at the MCI Center sold out very quickly as well. Plus, Raw Live this Monday is sold out as well.
His opponent, weighing 300 more pounds, Media!
And you mentioned about The Rock earlier on, Tom, about what happened with the Dudley boys being driven through the table courtesy of the Dudley Death Drop on orders from Stephanie McMahon Helmsley and her brother Shane. And I've got to wonder what The Rock is going to do live this Monday on Raw.
There's no telling, Kevin. The Rock is a dangerous man right now. He has nothing to lose. And I believe he's going to do his best to make Shane and Stephanie's life as miserable as he can.
Usually The Rock finds a way to entertain us, put a smile on everybody's face. I have a feeling nobody's going to be smiling if The Rock gets his wish this Monday on Raw. Well, looks like Midian's taking a liking to the ladies.
I tell you what, I'd offer you the girls, but sounds like to me, these people just want to see me kick your
Wow. I'm surprised Midian's even interested in the Godfather's ladies.
So it looks like Godfather Midian's set to go on. Wait a minute, where's he going now? What is Midian doing?
Wow.
Tom!
He looks like he's a little lonely.
Make him stop, Tom. Come on.
No, I'm not going near it.
Well, the Godfather's going to definitely do something to Midian. Look at what a coward. What a cowardly act by Midian.
What a smart act by Midian. Distracted the Godfather.
Now, wait a minute. Reversal.
Oh, good lord.
Shins first to the steps. Talk about a kneecapping.
I don't think the Godfather took too kindly to Midian manhandling his ladies there.
That's the one thing. You don't mess with the Godfather's ladies. He treats them so well. It's always a good time. It's a big party when the Godfather's around.
Oh.
Big boots in the midsection now. Midian turning it around. Clothesline. Short arm clothesline from Midian. And the early momentum that the Godfather enjoyed has been changed. Switched around 180 degrees. Midian, backbreaker. Two. Almost had him.
Wow.
We talk about the ladies in The Godfather's life. What about the lady in Edge and Christian's life? In Terry, that little she-devil.
What is up with Terry at No Way Out? We saw her turn her back on the Hardy Boys, and that allowed Edge and Christian to become the number one contenders for the WWF Tag Team title.
But ever since then, Terry has caused distraction between Edge and Christian and has led to less than prosperous times for the number one contenders. And every time Terry puts those little fingers over her head, symbolic of the little horns of the little she-devil, I've got to wonder what's really going through the mind of Terry. What truly is her agenda?
I think Edge and Christian are wondering the same thing. They don't know exactly what Terry has on her mind. Neither does anybody else in the World Wrestling Federation.
Earlier on in the hour, we saw the Godfather's tag team partner, D'Lo Brown, fall to S.A. Rios in what has to be an upset. Will the same fate befall the Godfather? Things are looking good. Will the man that says it ain't easy right now? Head of steam, off the ropes. I'd love this move.
Whoa!
Little added momentum there.
Godfather always puts a little added momentum in everything he does.
Getting that look in his eye, Tom.
Man.
Starting to feel worried for Midian. I think that's a first.
Looks like the train is getting ready to roll.
The conductor's coming through punching tickets.
Boom!
Guaranteed nobody's sleeping on the Godfather's train. Up on the shoulders. And down.
Wow.
The crunching.
Drop.
The pimp drop. This one is over. Godfather victorious here on Metal, but still to come, we'll have tag team action as the Big Boss Man and Prince Albert team up to take on Test and Taz.
And up next, SmackDown highlights as The Rock falls victim to the 3D, much to the delight of his enemies. Stay with us.
One will have planned for Triple H, Stephanie, Shane, and The Big Show this Monday on Raw. The Human Wrecking Machine debuts here on Metal. Will the number 13 be unlucky for his opponents here this week?
Contest is scheduled for one fall. Team number one has a combined weight of 530 pounds. Introducing first from the Red Hook section of Brooklyn, New York.
While The Rock faces a desperate situation, the mood is about to change here on Metal, Tom.
Be interesting to see how Test and Taz work together as a team, especially against the Boss Man and Prince Albert.
I'm not so sure that Taz will be able to control himself. He is just ripe with anger right now. Strong, confident. Back off the injured list, Test has never looked better. We will see if Test and Taz are able to form a partnership. Can they work together, or will they self-destruct when they do battle against the Boss Man and Prince Albert next on Metal? On Metal, the Lawman and his very willing and capable student are on their way to the ring. I don't think Taz is going to be able to control himself, like I said before. Prince Albert and the Big Boss Man have done their best to try to ruin Taz here in the World Wrestling Federation.
We saw the Boss Man and Prince Albert beat Taz down at No Way Out, and he kept coming back and wouldn't give up.
I think even the Boss Man and Prince Albert were surprised by Taz's toughness. No matter how many times Boss Man laid that stick to Taz, no matter how many times Prince Albert tried to bust up the ribs of Taz, he continued to get up time and time again.
Take a look at the determination on Taz's face. He's not backing up one bit from the Boss Man.
Like a Rottweiler, relentless. Comes from a very bad neighborhood, the Red Hook section of Brooklyn. It's like a third world country.
Wow.
It is a horrible section of town. Taz would be the first one to tell you.
Yeah.
He's already in a bad part of town, as Prince Albert and the Boss Man are looking to beat him up. But what? No matter what they do, Tom.
He's fighting his way out. The mood is changing because Taz won't back up from Prince Albert or Boss Man. Two on one.
WrestleMania is just 3 weeks away, as we know. And it has been sold out for months. But there is a way that you could be there live and in person. Just log on to WrestleMania.com to find out how you and a friend can win a free trip to WrestleMania. We ought to sign up for that contest, Tom.
What?
Because we can go to WrestleMania for free.
I'm going to WrestleMania for free.
So am I.
Yeah.
WrestleMania.com, the place to be. Tag made. Test is in. And he drops Prince Albert with an enormous boot right under Prince Albert's jaw.
And this will be a great test for Test against two big men in Prince Albert and the Boss Man.
Boy, and Boss Man going right after the back of Test. Powerbomb, two, and perhaps if not for Taz, this one would be over. Test suffered a back injury recently, has been on the injured list, but now pronounced fit and healthy. And look at this. Behind the referee's back, the double teaming. Good Lord.
Bossman and Albert have worked very well as a team in the recent weeks that they've got back together. Albert looking at the Boss Man as a mentor, and it's been working well for him.
We'll see if the Boss Man will have that advantage this Sunday night on Heat. The Boss Man to go one-on-one against Edge. Test up and over the top. And now getting set to deliver the pump handle slam. Oh, wait a minute. It would have been all she wrote there, but Prince Albert knew the counter. The escape. This is with the clothesline, though. Both men close on to each other. Both are down. This match at a critical point right now, Tom.
What a shot by both men. And Test needs to make a tag.
As does Prince Albert. Both the Boss Man and Taz are fresh on the apron. Test makes the tag. Here comes Taz. Relentless.
Whoa!
Wow!
What a suplex!
Runs right through the Boss Man next with the clothesline. There may be no stopping Taz here in the World Wrestling Federation. Prince Albert misses with the kick. And Taz misses. Wait a minute.
Boss Man was there to cut that one off.
The lights were just about to go out for Prince Albert as the Taz mission was locked in. But now all four men are going out to the floor.
Taz is right after the Boss Man.
Looking to pay the Boss Man back for everything done. At No Way Out, Taz and the Boss Man fighting up the ramp. Prince Albert fighting with Test up the ramp. Boss Man and Prince Albert trying to escape, Tom.
They're not letting them. Taz is hanging right with him.
Well, the bell sounds. The referee has counted to 10. This match ends in a double count out. But right now, with all the latest news, let's go to our good friend, Jonathan Coachman. Coach, take it away.
Show with all the odds stacked against him. Shane McMahon is the referee, but coming out on top, let's give props to The Rock right now.
Think about what that 27-year-old man was willing to do. If The Rock would have lost last Monday on Raw, he would have been gone from the World Wrestling Federation.
That's all the fame, all the fortune, all the notoriety that goes along with being The Rock here in the World Wrestling Federation. He put it all on the line just to get in the main event at WrestleMania.
And that, of course, would have been followed by just 1 month earlier, Mick Foley being gone from the World Wrestling Federation as well. Prince Albert snapping a neck to Inferno Kid. Prince Albert more aggressive than ever here in the World Wrestling Federation. Think about it. There would have been two. Wait a minute. Now a cover. Very close to the ropes. Two count only. There would have been two major superstars gone from the World Wrestling Federation in 1 month's time. Shane and Stephanie with a hand, of course, in both. And that, I think, had a lot to do with Vince McMahon returning.
Instead, now we have a triple threat match at WrestleMania involving The Rock, Triple H, and The Big Show. And this really puts Triple H at a disadvantage because the champion doesn't even have to be pinned to lose the championship.
Huge powerbomb for Prince Albert, and that once fragile coalition that existed between Triple H and Stephanie, Shane and the Big Show, is now over, Tom. It's outright warfare on the road to WrestleMania.
And it's interesting to see why Vince McMahon chose at this time to come back. He came back to save his business because of Shane. There's a cover again. Shane and Stephanie's ego getting out of control here in the World Wrestling Federation, trying to embarrass and humiliate The Rock.
Well, Vince McMahon surprised us all with his return Monday on Raw. Dead Triple H on his way to the ring. Clobbered his son Shane with a chair once he got there. Donned the referee shirt and made the three count himself. Sending The Rock to the main event at WrestleMania, where it will be The Rock, Triple H, and The Big Show for the World Wrestling Federation Championship. In each corner, Tom, think about it, at WrestleMania, there will be a McMahon, Stephanie in Triple H's corner. Shane will be in the Big Show's corner, and Vince McMahon is going to be in the corner of the people's chairs.
You got to believe that The Rock doesn't care who's in his corner. He just wants that shot at the triple threat WrestleMania main event.
Well, he has gotten it, and we're 2 weeks away, Sunday, April 2nd, from WrestleMania. Inferno Kid now getting caught up top, extending the arms. Prince Albert, incredibly strong at 375 pounds, has greatly benefited from his recent relationship, his working relationship with the Big Boss Man.
Prince Albert is agile, no doubt about it, and the Inferno Kid would do good just to get out of this match.
We'll see this a little later on. We're also going to talk about Mae Young. What a horrible week it's been for her. Huge maneuver there from Prince Albert. Hook of the leg. This one is over.
Here is your winner, Prince Albert.
Prince Albert is your winner. WrestleMania is 2 weeks away.
Big win for Prince Albert here on Metal. Folks, I'll tell you what, Connecticut, I'm talking to you. This is the coach, and we're coming back. That's right, the World Wrestling Federation coming back to the New Haven Coliseum in New Haven, Connecticut, Tuesday, May 9th, for SmackDown. Simply put, the most electrifying show on network television today. All your favorite WWF superstars will be there. The Rock, Triple H, Kane, The Big Show, X-Pac. How about Too Cool? How about this guy? The guy with the rhyme, the Road Dogg, Jesse James.
It's me, the D-O-double-G, the Road Dogg, and I may be DX's clown, but we're coming to New Haven for SmackDown, and if you ain't down, I got two words for you.
Always entertaining when the Road Dogg is around. Folks, once again, we're coming back to World Wrestling Federation to the New Haven Coliseum in New Haven, Connecticut, Tuesday, May 9th for SmackDown. Tickets on sale today, so get yours immediately.
Still to come here on Metal, the Godfather is in the house. Will he bring his ladies ringside when he faces the demonic Gangrel?
Plus, the incredible return of Vince McMahon, and who wasn't thrilled to see his sudden appearance?
And have we seen the last of Mae Young? We'll show you the Dudley Boys' horrendous actions last Monday and update her condition. Welcome back to Metal. Imagine a limousine, a private jet, and front row tickets to WrestleMania, all part of the WrestleMania All Day Long contest. Incredible!
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, weighing 496 pounds, Viscera!
Kevin, I know you can check out WrestleMania.com and find out all the details on the all-day-long contest.
J.R. Ryder!
Can you imagine what's going through J.R. Ryder's mind right now, hearing that weight, 496, looking up the aisle and seeing a man that looks like Viscera coming towards him with no regard for anyone's well-being?
That's a whole lot of bad attitude and aggression coming right at you.
Certainly is. We got to give congratulations out to Dean Malenko, becoming a light heavyweight champion last Monday on Raw, defeating S.A. Rios. But the actions of Eddie Guerrero, Tom, are rather disturbing. Here's a man who really did dislocate his elbow several weeks ago. But I'm wondering, is he hiding behind that injury now?
Well, I don't know if he's hiding behind the injury, but we saw him powerbomb Lita on the outside of the ring, and man, Eddie has something in him that might be a rage or a fury due to the injury that kept him out for so long.
Well, certainly, Eddie Guerrero was instrumental in Dean Malenko becoming the first radical to win WWF gold, as J.R. Ryder is launched, full slam down into the mat. Now, he's the first radical to become a champion here at the World Wrestling Federation. And, Tom, there's a story starting to circulate around the backstage area about maybe a little jealousy within the radicals.
Well, I understand that Chris Benoit, oh, my goodness!
Oh, Lord.
Chris Benoit wanted to be the first radical here in the World Wrestling Federation to capture gold, and once Malenko did it, maybe there's a little jealousy there, but I've got to wonder which superstar he's going to go after next to capture some of the gold here.
J.R. Ryder ducks under a clothesline. It's a fight for J.R. Ryder's life here, I would think. He's got to try to stay away as best he can. Runs right into the clutches. Oh, good Lord.
That's 496 pounds slamming you to the mat.
Viscera, very aggressive. Ooh. Can hit you at any time with any weapon possible. Head of steam, going to go for that. Oh, thought he was going to go for the big splash, but misses with a headbutt that time. Vis, a huge fan of rap music, and I know that everybody's talking about WWF Aggression, which hits the music stores everywhere this Tuesday, Tom. It's a very unique album.
And what an unbelievable collection of hip-hop artists.
Where else would you find Snoop Dogg, Run DMC, Cool Keith, Method Man, Ice-T, and many others, wow, all on one album? And the rap artists were inspired, Tom, by the Superstar's entrance themes.
How cool is that? Taking the DX theme and making a whole different song to it.
Not just DX, Tom, but Stone Cold Steve Austin's, The Rock, Kane, many others, all on WWF Aggression. It's at music stores everywhere this Tuesday. J.R. Ryder trying to quicken the pace and runs right into that huge leg of Viss.
Take a look at that aggression.
Sadistic pleasure. Viscera gets it. Delivering the pain and punishment here to J.R. Ryder this week on Metal. As we told you a little later on, the Godfather goes one-on-one against Gangrel. We'll take a look at the week in Mae Young's life and the shocking turn of events, not just what happened to Mae Young, but the comments by the fabulous Moolah afterward. Absolutely shocking.
Mae's not having a really good week.
Ryder doing his best once again. And now caught in a very precarious position.
Oh! That's a long way down for J.R. Ryder.
I think the outcome of this match, somewhat academic at this point. Viscera looks as if he could end it at any time. Maybe it'll be here. Head of steam. Ooh. There is the big splash, and that will do it. With a hook of the leg, this one is over.
Here is your winner, Viscera.
Viscera with a bad attitude this week.
Also, Tom, we're going to take a look at all the changes in WrestleMania's main event. Keep in mind, The Rock is now in a triple threat match with The Big Show and Triple H for the World Wrestling Federation Championship. And still to come, we'll show you the surprising return of Vince McMahon from last Monday's Raw, how he plowed a rift into the Coalition.
Plus, the dark and dangerous Gangrel takes on the fun-loving Godfather.
But up next, the horrifying story of Mae Young and the Dudley Boys. Metal continues. It's getting so a guy can't even enjoy a trip to an arcade anymore without having to put his hardcore title on the line. We're back on Metal.
The following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, at a combined weight of 492 pounds, Macho and Crusher, the Headbangers.
The Headbangers, the latest in a slew of challengers that have gone after Crash Holly. Remember, it was Holly who said he would defend that title anytime, anyplace, anywhere, 24-7. All you have to have is a WWF official with you.
Well, Crash has certainly had some unusual title defenses lately. I mean, in airports, hotels, laundromats, and even now at Funtown last Thursday.
What about Crash actually losing the hardcore title for a brief time to one of the Mean Street Posse members?
Wow, Pete Gass, I mean, for 8 seconds was the hardcore champion. Unbelievable.
And then, of course, Pete Gass, I guess, was too busy celebrating. Crash wound up rolling Pete up in baggage claim at Newark Airport and regained the title.
Wow.
Might be the closest the Posse ever gets to greatness. Who knows?
I don't know about that.
Well, the Headbangers here against Julio Fantastico and Ty Street. I'm sure the Headbangers will be thankful to get back in a regular regulation World Wrestling Federation ring after their struggles in the arcade with Crash last Thursday on SmackDown. I mean, you have to laugh at Crash Holly. I mean, it is. Sure, the hardcore title is all about being tough. Crash Holly's tough in his own right. But, man, I mean, to be on call 24-7 the way Crash Holly is.
I've got to give it to him. The champion that will defend his title anytime, any place. Give it to Crash Holly.
Julio Fantastico taking the measure to Thrasher so far. And, you know, I still can't get
the haunting memories of what happened to Mae Young last Monday on Raw out of my mind. And perhaps what could even be worse than what the Dudley Boys did is the words spoken by Mae's supposed friend. For years they've been best friends. What was the fabulous Moolah thinking when she said that Mae Young got what she deserved, Tom?
Kevin, it sounds like to me nothing but professional jealousy. I mean, for all this time, it was always Moolah, Moolah, Moolah. And before Mae Young came to the World Wrestling Federation, nobody had heard of her. And Moolah brought her here to the WWF and made her famous.
Well, of course, the fabulous Moolah. Wow. Nice move out of the headbangers there. And Ty Street, hard to the floor. Man. The fabulous Moolah was a champion here in the World Wrestling Federation for 28 years.
Wow.
Mae Young, you know, competed in relative obscurity. But she's the first competitor of any age, any generation, to compete in the ring in eight different decades. Mae Young's a star in her own right, with or without the fabulous Moolah.
But you can't deny that Moolah had a bigger and better name here at the World Wrestling Federation.
Very true, and that professional jealousy, I guess, is what caused the words from the fabulous Moolah. But no taking away from what the Dudley Boys did. Absolutely reprehensible, Tom. And of course, they are the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions. After what they did to Mae Young on Monday, they had to defend those tag team titles against the number one contenders on Thursday.
Yeah, Kevin and Edge and Christian were looking really good in that match. And oh, look at this!
Wait a minute, sunset flip. One, two. Two count only.
Edge and Christian were looking good until that she-devil Terry came down to ringside.
Well, Terry, of course, has been hot and cold, I guess you could say, with Edge and Christian. She's the reason that Edge and Christian were the number one contenders to begin with. She assisted in the victory over the Hardy Boys at No Way Out. But when Terry slid the chair into the ring, things I thought were looking good for Edge and Christian, but it wound up in that chair in the Dudley Boys' hands.
And while the Dudleys use the chair to their advantage and get the victory, if mistakes can happen, Kevin, no doubt about it, but when Edge saw Terry mocking them after the match, he turned around and gave her a spear like you wouldn't believe.
Well, I guess that little she-devil found out. You better be prepared to pay the price, and Ty Street's paying the price here at the hands of the headbangers. I mean, it was a momentary act of rage from Edge, but really, who could blame him after everything that Terry had put them through over the past few weeks?
A lot of pent-up frustration, no doubt about it, with Edge and Christian.
Well, I know that WrestleMania is 2 weeks away. It's Sunday, April 2nd, and all part of the huge weekend. Say hello to the Molars at Ty Street. All part of the huge weekend of WrestleMania, Tom, is Access, a one-of-a-kind event for the World Wrestling Federation. Truly a great opportunity for the fans to interact with the superstars of the World Wrestling Federation.
With 3 days, you have the best opportunity for a one-on-one interaction with your favorite WWF superstar. You'll have booths. You'll have a lot of displays, merchandise. It's going to be great.
Keep in mind, if you don't have a ticket for WrestleMania, you can get tickets for Access. We want you to be part of that. We want you to be part of every World Wrestling Federation live event. But just like WrestleMania, completely sold out, the King of the Ring sold out as well, Tom, in record time this past week.
Wow, that's a June event, sold out in 5 minutes.
Anytime you have the opportunity with World Wrestling Federation tickets when they go on sale, it's almost a public service announcement, folks. You better move fast, because tickets are definitely going to sell out quick. Ty Street has been receiving the brunt of the punishment here for the headbangers. And with the stage dive, I would say that this contest is over. Yes, indeed it is.
Here are your winners, the headbangers.
The headbangers, very impressive in what is certainly a very heated up tag team situation in the World Wrestling Federation. The Dudley Boys are the champions, but there are many teams pursuing them. And still to come here on Metal, we're going to see Gangrel emerge from the Ring of Fire to do battle with Good Time Charlie, the Godfather.
And up next, the McMahon family saga continues, and we'll find out what role Vince plays in it next.
WrestleMania. Thomas the Godfather makes his appearance here on Metal. Could you have imagined Stephanie McMahon Helmsley being a part of the Godfather's operation?
Kevin, Vince implied that Stephanie might be easy. I mean, that just goes to show you the feelings, how deep they run on each side.
I can't believe that Vince McMahon would actually say those things about his baby girl. I mean, that to me really shows exactly how heated this war now is in and amongst the McMahon family.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from the Red Light District, weighing 320 pounds, the Godfather!
Well,
Kevin, love him or hate him, Vince McMahon has always put the World Wrestling Federation first, and he's felt lately that both Shane and Stephanie have been running the business into the ground.
Well, with this power struggle between Shane and Stephanie, I guess you could say that mistakes were made. But there could be just as much action and excitement outside the ring during the main event at WrestleMania as inside, when Triple H, The Big Show, and The Rock all square off for the World Wrestling Federation Championship. That's Sunday, April 2nd, 2 weeks away, WrestleMania. The Godfather awaits the appearance of Danny Grell. We'll be back. That'll continue. WrestleMania, perhaps greater than ever this year with the inclusion of WrestleMania all day long. I'm going to give you some details about that in just a few moments. We're going to hear from the Godfather.
It's time once again for everybody to come aboard the... Man, I know that I ain't the only one. Is there any pimps up in this house? To all know that the Godfather be pimping hoes, then I want you, don't hide it, take it out, light it up for the Godfather, say
ominous feeling across the arena. I get chills on my arm every time Gangrel makes an appearance here in the World Wrestling Federation.
You know it's hot on top of the stage, though, where Gangrel comes through that ring of fire, Kevin.
It's going to be hot at WrestleMania as well. It's 2 weeks away, Sunday, April 2nd. And as I mentioned, you can be part of WrestleMania all day long. Can you imagine a 12-hour extravaganza?
You talk about the stars from the past, present, and possibly the future talking about their favorite WrestleManias. We'll have a pregame show as well as a postgame show. All the news that's going on at the time.
For just $15 extra, you get 12 hours of WrestleMania coverage. What a value that's going to be. WrestleMania all day long, Sunday, April 2nd, just part of the huge event that is WrestleMania.
Kevin, I've got to believe that The Rock has a tremendous advantage now with Vince McMahon in his corner going into that matchup. The Rock is going to feel great.
Plus, the disadvantage is really on Triple H because the champion doesn't have to get beat to lose his title.
No doubt about it. The Big Show going in there as well, wanting to capture the WWF Championship a second time. I mean, this is a triple threat match where all McMahons are going to be at ringside, and everybody has some kind of...
Wait a minute. I want to offer you the hose, I really do, but with those teeth and all this blood and... What y'all think? Should I offer him the hose?
Why not?
Hey, I'd offer you the hose, but sounds like to me, these people want to see me just kick your...
Now that's an offer of a different kind. Well, as the Godfather gets set to take on Gangrel, Tom, I know you are a big internet surfer, a huge fan of WWF.com. What huge news WWF.com is reporting about Heat this Sunday on USA.
Wow, I understand that Trish Stratus is going to make a special appearance on Heat.
Now, everybody who's a fan of the fitness world has seen Trish Stratus before. She is one of the top fitness models. She has been in just about every fitness magazine that there is. But the question is, what is she going to be doing here this Sunday?
Who knows? I mean, that is a big question. We're going to have to wait and find out on Heat. She's beautiful. I mean... My gosh, everybody wants to be in the World Wrestling Federation, it seems like, right now.
Well, Trish Stratus will be there this Sunday, as will Scotty Too Hotty. Member of Too Cool going one-on-one against now the former light heavyweight champion, S.A. Rios, who is going to be looking back to get back on the victory trail. Godfather up and over the top. Getting himself into some trouble here very early on against Gangrel. Heat is this Sunday, 7, 6 Central on the USA Network, and as we head to Raw this Monday, oh, wait a minute, in and around and into the steps goes the Godfather. You mentioned before that The Rock really is in the driver's seat as we head to WrestleMania. On the road to WrestleMania, Tom, with a stop, of course, this Monday live on Raw. what's going to happen between Triple H and the Big Show now that that once fragile coalition has been blown apart?
The animosity between Triple H and the Big Show has only grown, it seems like, in the past week. And Monday on Raw, where will it take us? Will they somehow get the coalition back together? Will it somehow come to men? Or will Vince McMahon again show that he is the premier businessman?
Think about all the combustible elements that are going to be there on Monday. The sibling rivalry that is growing now between Shane and Stephanie. The war that could exist between Triple H and the Big Show. And The Rock, who is definitely sitting pretty now, still has an enormous bullseye on him because he is part of the main event at WrestleMania.
And as we know, anything can happen in the WWF.
Godfather runs right into the boot of Gangrel. And the Gothic one clotheslines Godfather 2, almost had it.
Close.
Boy, heat this Sunday is going to be wild. We know Raw is War is going to be live this Monday. And we're all counting down to WrestleMania Sunday, April 2nd. Nobody home for Gangrel in the corner. The train leaving the station, Tom.
Oh, man. The roll-up.
One, two.
He got it.
Here is your winner, the Godfather.
Big win for the Godfather. Nobody does a post-game celebration any better.
Wow, look at the ladies this week.
Win or lose, the Godfather is always celebrating. But when Godfather gets his hand raised in victory, the party is all the sweeter. As I mentioned, we are counting down to WrestleMania. It's 2 weeks away.
Man.
Sunday, April the 2nd, the party continuing here with the Godfather.
The Godfather always kicking it. Right here on Metal. Folks, welcome back. As I mentioned earlier, the WWF, the World Wrestling Federation, coming back to the New Haven Coliseum in New Haven, Connecticut, Tuesday, May 9th for SmackDown, the most electrifying show, simply put, on network TV today. Tickets go on sale today, so don't delay. And if you want to relay to your friends, they go quickly. So get yours right now. All your favorite stars will be there. The Rock, Triple H, Kane, The Big Show. How about this guy? The Fat Man, P-H-A-T.
That's right, New Haven, Connecticut. You're looking at the world's most famous, and it belongs to Rikishi Fatu. I'm coming to your town to back that up.
Rikishi Fatu is going to be slapping that butt all the way to New Haven Tuesday, May 9th. Tickets on sale today.
Kevin Kelly, welcome everyone to Metal. WrestleMania is next Sunday, live on pay-per-view, and the main event has changed drastically.
The only tag team contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Greenwich, Connecticut, he gets Rodney Joey-Ann, the Mean Street Hussy.
It's now a fatal four-way elimination match. Last Thursday on SmackDown, Tom, Shane McMahon provided a little entertainment and a little preview with the posse.
Yeah, having his old buddies dress up like the Big Show's opponents in that fatal four-way match at WrestleMania.
Well, it was all a ruse. The posse victimized, the strong power of the Big Show shining through.
Their opponents, under the arm's weight of 492 pounds, Fox and Pressure, the Headbanger.
The Headbangers provide 10-team competition for the posse here as we kick off Metal. What a huge hour it's going to be, and what a night it was last Monday on Raw, Tom, where we saw what we thought was going to be the main event at WrestleMania, a triple threat match for the World Wrestling Federation Championship.
Well, that had to have been the hottest crowd in a long time,
oh, yeah.
And they got to see what they thought was going to be the main event at WrestleMania.
Triple H defended the World Wrestling Federation Championship successfully and thought everything was fine until Linda McMahon appeared on the scene and announced that now WrestleMania's main event will be a fatal four-way match, an elimination match. But of course, Triple H, The Big Show, and The Rock needed a fourth to make that complete.
And Kevin, that fourth was Mick Foley.
Linda McMahon made that shocking announcement as Raw went off the air on Monday. And of course, there will be a McMahon in each corner. Stephanie will be with her husband, Triple H. Shane will be with the Big Show. Rodney up and over on Bosh, but gets clotheslined for his trouble. Vince McMahon will be in The Rock's corner. And Linda McMahon will be with Mick Foley. Elbow, cover. Chad Patton gets to two before Rodney kicks out. So certainly, Tom, there appears to be a situation where we know the action's going to be hot inside. It's going to be very interesting outside the ring as well.
And can you imagine the feeling that Mick Foley felt when Linda McMahon called him and asked him if he wanted to be a part of the main event at WrestleMania?
Oh, man, Joey Abs launched into the lights. Well, one half of Mick's dream has come true. He will be in the main event at WrestleMania. Now the second half, he has to win the title. But of course, that was all on Monday. But the family drama, the saga continued on Thursday with perhaps the most shocking thing we have ever seen in the WWF.
What?
When Stephanie McMahon Helmsley slapped her mother, Linda.
Unbelievable. I mean, everyone was in shock, including Linda, brought to tears.
Oh, what a scene that was. And the actions of Stephanie, indescribable. It certainly shows how much volatility there is within the McMahon family. And now look at Pete Gass.
Doing what he does best.
Giving an opening now to Joey Abs, who capitalizes on it very nicely. Tom, you've worked with the posse extensively. How would you evaluate their development?
I think they're coming along fine. The more matches you have, the more chances you have to win one.
Look at this now. Off the tag. It's a nice double teaming for the posse.
Not bad.
Hook at that leg. Two count only. Well, I know they were frustrated in the hardcore situation with Crash Holly, who continues to put his title on the line 24-7, 365.
Yeah, but Pete is a former hardcore champion
for
now.
All of 8 seconds, like a rodeo cowboy. Yeah. Joey Abs in off the tag. Posse has isolated Thrasher here. We, of course, will take you back to Raw and to SmackDown. We'll give you highlights from the past week. We'll show you the drama that unfolded within the McMahon family. Misses with the moonsault. We'll show you how the fatal four-way elimination match for the WWF Championship at WrestleMania next Sunday came to be. Plus, we'll start with the huge preview of WrestleMania. And a tag is made. Mosh in the ring. Clean it house now. Members of the Mean Street Posse flying. Mosh looking terrific. Full slam on Rodney. And now one for Joey Abs as well. Thursday was a horrible night for the Mean Street Posse in their mocking fashion.
Man.
And here on Metal, it's not much better.
With friends like Shane McMahon, I'm not so sure you need enemies.
Boy, could Shane McMahon be in control of the World Wrestling Federation champion? Can the Big Show win the fatal four-way elimination match? It's anybody's ballgame. Next Sunday, live on pay-per-view. Out of the corner, nicely done. Joey Abs now calling the play. Rodney's going up top.
I don't know.
Oh, wait a minute, Crash. Oh, Mosh in the nick of time before Rodney was about to fly. Looks like Rodney's going to take flight anyway. Face first to the mat. Hook of the leg. This one is over.
Here are your winners, the Enzo.
Well, Pete's not happy about it at all. Neither is Joey Abs. What's this?
No celebration now for the Headbangers. Up on the shoulders, extending the arms, Joey Abs sends Bosh down.
That's one way to get even.
Taz battles Gang, Grell, and a whole lot more in the hour, but we are counting down to WrestleMania. Here with the latest is the coach.
Hello, everybody. This is the coach in New Haven. The WWF is coming back live for SmackDown. Tuesday, May 9th at the New Haven Coliseum. Tickets are on sale now, but they will not last long. Let's talk about WrestleMania. In the main event, a fatal four-way elimination matchup for the WWF title. The champion, Triple H, taking on the Big Show, The Rock, and Mick Foley, a member of the McMahon family in every corner. A tremendous challenge for the champion, Triple H.
WrestleMania, the biggest show of them all. And it's only fitting that the game goes in the World Wrestling Federation champion. And it'll be fact that the game walks out the World Wrestling Federation champion. Why? Because I am that damn good.
A very confident Triple H. The only question now is who will walk out of WrestleMania the champion? You can see it live next Sunday only on pay-per-view.
Still to come on WWF Metal, the human wrecking machine, Taz, will be in action. do his battle with Gangrel a little later on.
Plus, Raw highlights as a triple threat match for WrestleMania turns into a fatal four-way with the addition of Mick Foley.
And up next, super heavyweights collide. Sexual chocolate Mark Henry battles Viscera. Stay with us. Battle continues. This week, WWF Metal is brought to you by WWF SmackDown for PlayStation. Everything inside the ring and almost anything out.
And by 1-800-CALL-ATT for collect call.
And by Aaron, powerful protection against your worst smelling sweat.
It's sexual, baby.
We are back on Metal.
I'll give it all to you.
It has certainly been a rough month in the life of sexual chocolate Mark Henry. His Lady May Young no longer by his side, thanks to the Dudley Boys.
Unbelievable.
With the schedule for one fall. Introducing first from Simsby, Texas, weighing 380 pounds, sexual chocolate Mark Henry.
And Tom, despite Mark's best efforts, the Dudley Boys a couple of weeks ago did indeed get to May Young. Never be the same again.
Weighing 496 pounds,
a big old bull's going to be in the ring here. Mark Henry battling Viscera. But of course, the Dudley Boys did not stop with Mae Young. Recently, they also put The Rock through a table during a match that was set up by Triple H and Stephanie McMahon Helmsley. But this past Thursday on SmackDown, Vince McMahon gave The Rock an opportunity for revenge.
And it was Bubba Ray Dudley who wound up going against The Rock, but D-Von was the one who wound up going through a table thanks to The Rock.
Plus, the Dudley Boys getting involved in, really preventing the naming of a number one contending tag team last Monday on Raw. Of course, it was a night of elimination matches. It culminated in a battle royal. There were four teams involved, eight superstars altogether, Mark Henry and Viscera, starting off very quickly on one another. And Tom, when all was said and done last Monday on Raw, it wound up with Edge and Christian and the Hardys, but the Dudleys really told a story there.
The Dudleys put both the Hardys and Edge and Christian through tables, trying to wreak some kind of carnage and keeping them out of the tag team competition here.
Viscera pounding away on Mark Henry, but it was Thursday on SmackDown where Vince McMahon took care of the Dudley Boys, really put them in their place, not only giving The Rock an opportunity for revenge, but also naming the Hardys and Edge and Christian code number one contenders. And Tom, we're going to have a first ever at WrestleMania.
A first ever triangle ladder match between the Dudleys, the Hardy Boys, and Edge and Christian. And I've got to believe this might weigh very heavily in Edge and Christian and the Hardy Boys. The Dudleys are at a disadvantage, in my opinion.
Well, of course, the Hardys and the Dudley Boys battled at the Royal Rumble. It was a few months earlier, back at the end of 1999. We saw the Hardys and Edge and Christian redefine the ladder match. But that definition is going to be elevated one more notch. Next Sunday, live on pay-per-view, the tag team titles will be high above the ring in a triangle ladder match. The Dudleys, Edge and Christian, and the Hardys. WrestleMania is certainly shaping up to be a spectacular event. Viscera, head of steam. Can he land the squash? Oh, boy. One of the few times in Mark Henry's career where he is at a weight disadvantage.
Man. I thought Mark had a little fire in his eyes coming down that ramp, but right now, Viscera's taking all that fire right out of it.
You know, the emotional toll that the entire situation with Mae Young has taken on Mark Henry has been drastic. I think Mark is doing his best to compete week after week. Double clothesline. Both men are down. We got a lot more great action still to come in the hour. We'll see Taz go one-on-one against Gangrel. We've got Raw and SmackDown highlights as well. Plus, we'll show you the most shocking thing perhaps ever in the WWF. Last Thursday on SmackDown, Stephanie McMahon Helmsley slaps Mother Linda McMahon, breaking the poor woman's heart.
What in the world do you think Stephanie was thinking?
Well, I know what word she used, and we certainly cannot repeat it here. But it was verbiage that we never thought we would hear, actions we never thought we would see, and the smirk on the faces of both Stephanie and Triple H made me sick.
Talk about dysfunctional.
Well, now Viscera finds himself in a rather precarious position. Mark Henry lining him up and landing. Oh, man. Despite the fact Viscera has a 100-pound weight advantage on Mark Henry, a maneuver like that could really slow Big Vis down.
Snap your neck.
And now, can Mark Henry land? Boom. The leg drop. He does it. Cover. This should do it. Two and 9/16.
9/16?
A little more than 2.5.
Wow. That's close.
Boy, what a close event it's going to be. Too close to call. The WrestleMania main event is now a fatal four-way elimination match. Triple H, the World Wrestling Federation champion, The Big Show, The Rock, and Mick Foley. Oh! Members of the McMahon family in each of the four superstars' corners. WrestleMania is live next Sunday on pay-per-view. We'll be talking more about that event a little bit later on. Oh, oh man! Viscera misses that time with the splash. Mark Henry and Vis slugging it out center of the ring. What a kick! Landing the spin kick is Big Vis, who now perhaps sees a vital opportunity. Head of steam, coming off the ropes. Oh, man, driving the wind right out of Mark Henry's sails. This one's over.
Take a look at the attitude on Vis.
Here is your winner, Viscera.
A battle of exhaustive proportions between Mark Henry and Viscera. WrestleMania is shaping up to be the greatest night ever in World Wrestling Federation history. We're going to talk more about that big event, plus other matches that have been signed for next Sunday, live on pay-per-view at WrestleMania. But still to come here on WWF Metal, we'll see S.A. Rios with Lita in his corner, team with the returning Stevie Richards against Kyantai.
And up next, things heat up between Kurt Angle, Chris Benoit, Chris Jericho. The highlights from Raw and SmackDown.
Of his right shoulder landed Taka on the injured list. But Taka exceeded his therapy back perhaps 2 months early to full-time competition now in the World Wrestling Federation.
Wow. At a combined weight of 451 pounds, S.A. Rios and Stevie Richards.
Well, both Lita and S.A. Rios with a bit of a smile on their faces, they're trying to figure out the chameleon-like Stevie Richards.
I guess S.A. Rios has a little confusion on his face.
Well, Stevie Richards is back after an injury as well, a foot injury he sustained back in November, and Lita back on the mend as well. It is great to see all these participants healthy in this contest. Why is Stevie Richards just so bent on dressing up like everybody, Tom?
You know, it's one of those identity crises. I think Stevie Richards doesn't know what he's supposed to be, who he is. Kind of schizo.
I think Stevie needs crisis counseling. Funaki starting off very quickly with the former light heavyweight champion, S.A. Rios, bounding away on the former champion. Ooh. But S.A. answering back, shots to the midsection, up and over. Funaki quickening the pace. S.A. one step quicker. Boot to the midsection now. S.A., what's he going to do here with Funaki? Up, down, tornado DDT. It's got to feel good for Funaki to have his regular tag team partner, Taka Michinoku, in his corner. But wait a minute.
What's Lita doing in the ring?
S.A.'s regular partner, Lita.
Boom!
Anything S.A. can do, Lita tries to do better. The tornado DDT behind the referee's back. 2-0. Would have been a 3 if not for Taka.
Lita looks like she might have got a little hurt on that one.
High impact offense from all the participants of this contest. Let's take another look, Tom, first at S.A. Rios.
Watch a smooth tornado DDT.
Then Lita answers with one of her own.
Man.
Very unique combination. Lita got her first opportunity at the Women's Championship last Thursday on SmackDown and took the champion Jacqueline to the hilt.
Very impressed by Lita.
And what about Ivory almost becoming the hardcore champion, Tom?
Wow. Trying to give Crash a massage. I mean, it just goes to show you, if you're going to put the championship up 24 hours, here's a cover.
Two, almost had him.
Man. 24 hours a day, you better be prepared 24 hours a day.
Well, Ivory certainly rubbed Crash the wrong way. And really, any place, any time, Crash Holly will put that title on the line. All you gotta have is a World Wrestling Federation official in tow. Is the crowd counting along in Spanish with Stevie Richards?
Oh, man.
Maybe Stevie's trying to get into this whole Latin thing, you know, with Mark Anthony and Ricky Martin and Enrique Iglesias. Stevie Ricciardo.
Yeah, he's got a way to go, Kevin. Yeah. Stevie Ricardo.
I like it. I like the sound of it. Now Taka's in. And of course, boy, you talk about debuts in the World Wrestling Federation. This past week, there were two big debuts. The first one with the Big Boss Man. Oh, man. Drop kick right to the face.
Taka hasn't lost a step.
Talking about the Big Boss Man and his running buddy, Bull Buchanan. What a debut they made last Sunday on Heat. Equally impressive. making a definitive statement against the Godfather both Monday on Raw and Thursday on SmackDown. So who is this Bull Buchanan?
I don't know, Kevin, but I can guarantee you this. Trish Stratus made a debut that won't let anybody forget that she is now in the World Wrestling Federation. I mean, oh, man. Coming out with Test and Proud Prince Albert?
Yeah, the fitness guru debuted last Sunday on Heat, checking out both Test and Albert's matches and then bringing out the tandem Monday on Raw. And then Test and Albert got their first victory. The team of TNA, very successful against the team of Head Cheese. Well, Al Snow and Steve Blackman.
Yep.
And now Taka going for a tornado of his own. Great counter from Stevie. Stevie kick. In any language, in any culture, the Stevie kick is muy importante.
And it put Taka down.
Both spend even to make a tag. Stevie tags first. S.A. Rios is in. Taka could not tag Funaki. Funaki comes in anyway. Greeted rather rudely. Nobody home for Taka. What wild action here. A little later on, Taz takes on Gangrel. More Raw and SmackDown highlights as well. S.A. elevates the pace. Nobody home. Taka going up top. Oh, Stevie glancing blow at Funaki on the floor.
Oh, there's high flying action. Look out!
Pirate District for S.A. Rios. And now with Funaki and Stevie occupied on the floor. Boomsaw! What a victory! Look at Lita!
No, she's not.
Yes, she is.
Oh, man!
Oh! Uno, dos, tres!
Here are your winners, Stevie Richard and S.A. Rios.
What a win by S.A. Rios and Stevie Richards?
Maybe Stevie Ricardo. I kind of like that.
You would.
Tag team action, very successful team. S.A. Rios, Stevie Richards here on Metal. But still to come, we got a lot more action, including the gothic one, Gangrel. We'll be on the rise against the human wrecking machine, Taz.
And up next, Stephanie sends a drastic message to Mother Linda McMahon.
WrestleMania is next Sunday. It's live on pay-per-view. But for the first time ever, you'll be able to savor 12 hours of WrestleMania coverage for just 15 extra bucks. You're going to relive the history of the first 15 WrestleManias, plus you'll see the huge event at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific, WrestleMania next Sunday.
Well, Kevin, the WrestleMania weekend really begins with WWF Access, the Fan Festival, which runs next Friday through Sunday at the Anaheim Convention Center.
Of course, the WrestleMania event at the Arrowhead Pond is sold out, but even if you don't have a ticket to WrestleMania, check out Access at the Anaheim Convention Center next Friday through Sunday. It's a one-of-a-kind. And boy, the World Wrestling Federation is certainly excited about the entire WrestleMania weekend.
You'll have a chance to get autographs from all your favorite superstars, Kevin. Even the HBK, Shawn Michaels,
wow,
will be there.
Well, that's going to be a great treat. I know all the superstars are anxious to get out to Southern California, and I know that four WWF superstars cannot wait to vie for the World Wrestling Federation Championship. But what about the McMahon family saga that really took center stage last week? Within the native of the Red Hook section of Brooklyn, New York.
Gary Graham, you blood-sucking freak! You're gonna get choked out with the Taz mission right here, right now! And if you don't like that, there's two things you can do about it. Nothing and like it!
Wow. Boy, it's, you know, Taz is tough in his own right, but when he tells you he's going to choke you out, I mean, what is Gangrel thinking about now?
He's thinking about not getting choked out.
Well, Gangrel knows that this crowd is solidly behind the human wrecking machine. a man who has battled his whole life to survive, fighting to survive the streets of Red Hook Section of Brooklyn, New York, throwing the referee aside. This is going to be a brawl.
Doesn't matter who Taz has been in there with, he's never backed up a step.
Gangrel, Hennessey, off the ropes, runs into a clothesline. And what about what Stephanie McMahon Helmsley did to her mother, Linda, Tom? Let's talk about it one more time. A slap in the face and words we never thought we'd hear Stephanie say.
That had to have been one of the most shocking things we've ever seen here in the World Wrestling Federation. Not only the slap, but to call her mother what she did. I mean, face to face, it's got to be heartbreaking for Linda McMahon.
You know, and what do Vince and Shane think about all of this? What's going to happen next with this McMahon family saga? We still got one more week to go until WrestleMania, until all four members of the McMahon family will be in respective corners for the fatal four-way elimination match for the World Wrestling Federation Championship. We know Raw is live this coming Monday, and really anything could happen on the road to WrestleMania. Gangrel now beginning to open up some offense of his own. Let's see what he can do. Head of steam, corkscrew elbow, cover, hook of the leg, two count only. And WrestleMania's card, Tom, is certainly shaping up as well. We talked earlier on about the two-fall triple threat rules match. Kurt Angle putting both the European and Intercontinental titles on the line against Chris Jericho and Chris Benoit.
And Kurt Angle could lose both titles without even getting pinned.
The first fall will be for the European title. The second fall for the Intercontinental. Taz is gnawing on the leg of Gangrel. Boy, and I know the Dudley boys face the fate of not having to be pinned and losing their title. The tag team titles will be 20 feet above the ring, Tom, in the first ever triangle ladder match.
And I've got to believe the ladder match favors either Edge or Christian and the Hardys.
We all remember the incredible ladder match from No Mercy in October of 1999 between Edge and Christian and the Hardy boys. And what about the Royal Rumble tag team table match between the Hardys and the Dudleys? Certainly, with this triangle ladder match, really, the intensity is going to be turned up another notch next Sunday, WrestleMania, live on pay-per-view.
And what about Kane and Rikishi against X-Pac and Road Dogg?
Wait a minute. Two count almost had him.
Wow.
Where certainly we saw X-Pac and the Road Dogg trying to put Kane and Rikishi against one another Monday on Raw. And then the tag team matchup is signed with Kane and Rikishi teaming up for the first time ever. And will Kane ever be able to settle the score with X-Pac? We'll find out next Sunday at WrestleMania. And now, Gangrel. Wait a minute, reversal. Taz off the ropes. Gangrel misses with the elbow. Taz missions applied.
Wow, he tapped out quick on that one.
Fulfills his prophecy. He chokes out Gangrel here on Metal. Winner by Taz mission. That's Taz.
A big win for Taz. New Haven, don't forget, the WWF is bringing SmackDown live to the New Haven Coliseum Tuesday, May 9th. Tickets on sale right now, but they will not last long. Let's talk about WrestleMania in a two-fall, double title, triple threat match. Chris Jericho, Chris Benoit take on the Eurocontinental champion, Kurt Angle.
Hey, this is Kurt Angle, your Eurocontinental champion and Olympic hero. I'll be wrestling in WrestleMania April 2nd in a triple threat match against Chris Benoit and Chris Jericho. I'll be using my three I's, intensity, integrity, and intelligence, as I beat these guys once again. Don't miss it.